systems and applications, because you know the nowadays beamforming or multi-beam antenna is a very hot topic, because due to the 5G or 6G beyond 5G, because you have to use the millimeter wave for base station or connectivity or other applications or satellite, you have to use the millimeter wave, because millimeter wave can get the wider bandwidth. If you have the wider bandwidth, you can get transfer the more data and faster. So the demand of the nowadays, like you want to play the 3D video or you want to watch the 3D movie, games, etc. So you need very fast, very large data transfer. So that's why the beamforming antenna is required. So the why we need the beamforming antenna? If you go the millimeter wave, and if you know the millimeter wave, the path loss is increased. To compensate the path loss, so you have to design the high gain antenna. High gain antenna means you have a narrow band. So if you have narrow band antenna, so you just cover the very narrow area. So if you want to cover wider band, so you have to have beam steering antenna. This is the very, very important for connectivity nowadays. So outline of my presentation, motivation, why we need the beamforming antenna, beam steering antenna, and then I will give you the overview on the beam steering, beamforming, beam scanning antenna technology, and then I will discuss in more detail grid array antenna for beam steering application. And then I will present some frequency scanning leaky wave antennas, and some I will show you some design examples, and I will present some measurement and simulated result on the leaky wave antenna, and then I will present some special application of the leaky wave antennas, and then finally I will conclude my presentation. So as you know, the motivation for if you design the beam steering antenna, you have to have, one is the very important thing is the wide coverage. You should have the wide coverage to cover the almost whole hemisphere from minus 90 to plus 90. But if this is not possible for the smart antenna, so this is very challenging to get the wide coverage. And the other problem is the low profile. If you want to place the antenna on satellite or in aeroplane, you have to have the low profile antenna to reduce the drag, other problem for aeroplane. And the third one is the cost and power efficient. The cost also very important, and the power consumption for the antenna array is also very important. So have to design the low profile, low cost, and low power consumption. So you know the connectivity is very important. And if you are playing, if you are in the plane, you want to watch a movie, 3D movie, so you need a very large data transfer or video transfer. So you have to have the large bandwidth. So large bandwidth, we can get the at millimeter wave, like Ka band. You can have the very large bandwidth from 27 to 31. And you are traveling in the ship or high train, so you have to connect with your family or your teammate, or you are planning to lecture, you can give the lecture if you have the connectivity. So connectivity is the very, very important in nowadays. So there are a lot of application in connectivity. So if you have the in plane is the moving, like connectivity in motion, so you have to have the beamforming antenna to always connect with the satellite to get the connectivity, to get the information, news, and other thing. So you need to connect the satellite. So plane is flying, right? So you have to change the antenna beam direction based on the speed or based on the location, other thing. So wherever you fly, you need to connect. So connectivity is very, very important. Whether you are traveling in air or you are in sea or you are on ground. And the other important coming the 5G connectivity or mobile base station, you have to have beamforming antenna to connect connect everything. So the 5G plan is the connect everywhere for everyone and everything. So there are a lot of applications: beamforming antenna, airborne system, satellite, radar, 5G, drone, UAV, or imaging system, tracking, detections. So the imaging system also, if you want to very good image, so you have to go the millimeter wave, because you want to the very fine resolution. So if you go the millimeter wave, so you have to design high gain antenna to compensate the path loss, because if you go the millimeter wave, path loss is very high. So the beam width is very narrow. To cover the large area, so you need to design the beamforming antenna to cover the at least large area to scan. So the beam scanning antenna is the key for connectivity or for everything nowadays, because if you go the millimeter wave, even the low frequency 6G, you need to have the beamforming antenna for connectivity. So some application, the automotive radar, 24 gigahertz, 77 gigahertz, navigation, tracking, and you have the inter-satellite communication, LEOs and GEO. So you need to have the beamforming antenna, because this is working at the Ka band, millimeter wave. And on the move SATCOM, you need to, because the connectivity in motion, you need to beamforming antenna, 5G, cellular communication, space systems, short range, ultra high speed and data communication, WLAN, airborne application, imaging system, and scanning system. So if you go to the airport, so there the scanning system, they also use the millimeter wave and use the beam scanning antenna. You can scan the whole body in one go. Otherwise, you have to have a very large beam width. For millimeter wave, path loss is very high, so you have to compensate the path loss to design the high gain. So for connectivity, you have to have the smart antenna or reconfigurable antenna. So reconfigurable antenna, we can have the different type reconfigurable antenna. We have the frequency reconfigurable antenna, or pattern reconfigurable antenna, or polarization reconfigurable antenna. You can see the polarization. We can switch the polarization linear to circular, right hand, left hand, based on the switching or pin diode. You can use the pin diode. You can switch the polarization very easily, design the reconfigurable polarization based antenna. The other is the tuning. If you want to change the frequency band, you have to have the frequency reconfigurable. So this also can be designed based on the vector diode, or you have the liquid crystal based. You know, the liquid crystal can change the dielectric permittivity of the substrate based on the biasing voltage. Apply the biasing voltage, you can change the frequency if you change the permittivity of the substrate. So vector diode also, you can change the capacitance. So means you are changing the effective dielectric constant, so frequency can tune. For beamforming application, the pattern reconfigurable is the important for the smart antenna or connectivity in motion. So you need very smart beamforming or beam switch beam or multi-beam antenna to change the beam in different direction very fast. So the beam steering, beam scanning antenna system requirement. So the first requirement is the beam steering angles should be wide enough to communicate with satellite or communication system, because if you go the frequency, if the frequency increasing, the path loss is square of the frequency. It means path loss increase by square of the frequency. So if you go the millimeter wave, path loss increase. So you have to design the high gain antenna to compensate the path loss. So if you have a high gain antenna, the beam is narrow, so you can improve the signal to interference or noise ratio also. And the other requirement is the cost efficient, low cost and low power consumption, and the low profile, low weight for if you go the satellite. So, and if you mount the antenna on the high speed train or other high speed vehicles, so you have to design the low profile. And the system should be easy to use, and system can generate the multi-beam or dual beam to connect the simultaneously different users or different satellite in like LEOs, GEOs or other, if you have the different location to connect or scanning. So you have the multi-beam antenna, also very important. So the some questions to ask yourself, why beam steering antenna at millimeter wave, and what are the application of the beam steering beamforming antenna system, and what are the typical reconfigurable antenna? So how we can make the reconfigurable antenna? So you should know these things. And because the path loss is very high at millimeter wave, so the to compensate the path loss, you have to design the high gain antenna. High gain means you have the narrow beam means you are covering very narrow area. To cover the wide area, you should have the wide beam steering. So this is the main for millimeter wave beam steering antenna. So the antenna beam width is narrow. If you have the fixed beam, so you just cover the very narrow area. If you not tune the beam, so you just cover the very narrow area. Otherwise, you have to rotate by mechanically, or we have to rotate. We have to change the beam. We have to steer the beam to cover the large area. So the types of beamforming antenna, beamforming systems, they are the mechanical. You can steer the, like you have the narrow beam antenna, high gain antenna, you steer the mechanically beam in the different direction, whatever direction, desired direction you can steer. The other one type is the main type is the electronic. Electronics means phased antenna, digital beam forming, analog hybrid beam forming. And other main type is the lens antenna or multi beam quasi optical system. Lens antenna is type of the fixed beam because you have the you are exciting the lens with the different patches at the fixed direction. And the other one is the Butler matrix Rotman lens also can generate the multi beam. These are Butler matrix Rotman lens and the fixed beam techniques. You have the like 4 beam or 8 beam you can generate in the fixed direction, you cannot change. And the other type is the transmit array and reflect array, multi-port grid array antenna, and the frequency scanning leaky wave antenna, electronically scan leaky wave antenna. And other type by the electronic tunable material based. If you have the tunable material, you can add the delay based on the adding the some increasing the permittivity or decreasing permittivity, you can the add the delay, you can scan the beam. The other type is the conformal type, sector type and array antenna. So I will go one by one. What is the disadvantage, advantage of this beam steering antenna? So the mechanical antenna, mechanical beam steering antenna is very good because you can get the beam in any direction without changing any gain or any side lobe problem, other problem. This is the best antenna to cover the wide coverage with without any like scan loss, other problem. So only the main disadvantage of the mechanical steerable antenna is the slow beam scanning. This is the main disadvantage. Otherwise, mechanical beam steering antenna is the best because in all direction you can get the same gain no side lobe problem, no grating lobe problem, no other problem, because it just rotate in all direction. And like this, the K-band antenna, you can rotate the by using the motor in any direction. And this is the, like, you can rotate this antenna like this, and this one also rotate like this. Elevation and azimuth, you can rotate in all direction. Only the problem is the main problem, main disadvantage is the slow beam scanning, slow beam speed. And other disadvantage is the heavy, bulky, and maintenance, because they're using the motor, so motor sometimes is making some noise and other things. And other one, this is the, just to, they use the some green type graded dielectric plate, because they use the different dielectric slot inside the plate. And the, if you rotate the plate, you can change the phase. Based on the change in the phase, you can rotate the beam. So this is the also very good, and based on the mechanical rotation. So the main disadvantage is the slow beam scanning speed for mechanical antenna. Otherwise, very good. So the other main technique is the electronic beam forming. This is the very good. You can form the beam very fine, or the very fast beam scanning. This is the advantage of the this type of the beam forming. The issue is the main is the cost and power consumption and complexity. Because if you want to the 40 dB, 35 dB gain antenna, you need around 1,000 of element at Ka band. So for electronic beam antenna, beam string antenna system, so each element should connect with phase shifter. So phase shifter cost is very high at the millimeter wave. So if you consider the 1,000 of the phase shifter and 1,000 of the element, and then you have the feeding network and other control RF chain, or and you have to connect the phase shifter. So this is very complex. And that's why the cost is very high and the complexity. And the other one is the digital beamforming also is very, very power hungry. You need very, very high power. So because the each element in digital beamforming work as a transceiver. So the each element should be connect AD and DA converter. So this is the very power hungry. So and complexity also increase, and cost. Because if you consider the one IC is cost around $150. So if you consider the 1,000 of IC, so very, very, very expensive. So the digital and RF beamforming can achieve the high scan resolutions and fast beam scanning. This is the advantage. You can get the very fine beam resolution, and you can get the fast beam scanning. And this is the based on the software control, so you can generate the beam in any direction, desired direction, very fast. The cost and high power is the main disadvantage of these type of beam string, electronic beam string system, antenna system. So there are some company in the market. So they're designing the K-band antenna for airborne or satellite application, because they have the two panel, one receiving and transmitting. And ThinkPad, you can see one is the K-band, one is the lower band, uplink and downlink. This is the 30 gigahertz and this is 20 gigahertz. And these are both, all product have the downlink and uplink. And they are the player of the, these main player of the designing the electronic beam steering antenna system based on the phase. These are the conventional electronic beam forming antenna. Conventional means you have the physically phase shifter connected with the each element. So you can steer the beam. So other type is the unconventional electronic beam steering antenna. Unconventional means you have the different technology, means the Elkin company use the liquid crystal. So liquid crystal in each element and then controlled by the biasing voltage. So each element should connect with the biasing to get the phase delay. And this is the, I think, new startup launched this year, this product. And this they claim this is the very low cost and low power consumption. This is the main disadvantage. And they claim around 5 times they can reduce the cost and power consumption compared to the conventional phased array antenna. So this is the just new, I think this year they launched the product. And the other one is the K-Meta, also based on the, they use the vector diode or liquid crystal combined, but they don't have the product on K-band. So they just designed for the KU band. And the other type is the isotropic. They use the lens concept with multi-beam antenna. You have the multiple pairs to excite the lens. And this is also very new company, but they're designing differently. They also claim to reduce the cost and power. The other one is the they use the holographic techniques to generate the beam in different direction. These are all unconventional, is the cost effective, cost efficient, and the power efficient. This is the advantage. So this is the one example of the phased array antenna for dual circular polarized phased array antenna. You can see the 1024 element at Ka band. And these are the element, and these are the IC, because each IC connected with the 4 patches. You can see here, and this is the IC, and this is the 4 patches, and this is the dual circular polarized, one feed with right hand, another feed is left hand. So these IC connected with the 4 patches at the unit, you can see here, to design the phased array antenna. Circular dual circular polarized phased array antenna at Ka band. So this IC cost is very high, and you have the feeding networks and other things is very, very complex, and then you have the control system, and you can see here, beam scanning is only the limited plus minus 30 degree if you consider the axial ratio. And the other problem is this one, if you scan the plus minus 30 degree, you have the scanning loss around 4.5. It means at both side is the gain is the, at 30 degree gain is the 4.5 less than both side. So this is the, we call the scan loss. So in mechanical beam steering, you don't have this one. 4.5 is very, very big number for antenna, because 3 dB means half. So if you want to cover this loss, 4.5, you have to double, more than double the antenna size. So this is the issue in the phased array antenna, and this is very big issue. And because this is the physics, physics problem, because this scanning depend on the single antenna element radiation pattern. If you have the wider radiation pattern or single element, you can get the wider beam. Like if you have the plus minus 90 degree radiation pattern of the single element, you can get the at least 3 dB gain loss plus minus 90. So if you have the single element radiation beam width is the 60 degree or 120 degree, you can cover only plus minus 60 degree with 3 dB loss. Yeah. So this is the this is the element design, only the one chip. This is the one IC, and this is the antenna, 4 antenna. You can see the how many layer for designing. You need the power feeding network, power and control system layers, and these are the only the antenna layer is this one. So you need so many line to control the element. And you can see the here, the scanning loss. because in the board side is the maximum, and then reducing if you scan is around 60 degree, you can reduce, you can have the scanning loss. So this is the some disadvantage of the phased array compared to the mechanical beam steering antenna. And this is the other example from the physics 2. They demonstrate the four beam antenna to connect with the multiple user. I think they have designed first time for multi-beam antenna design with based on the IC. This is the IC. You can control the beam based on the signal processing. Based on the port and signal processing, you can control the beam, four beam. You can generate the simultaneously four beam with one antenna system. Because you need to, if you go the 5G base station or other, if you want to use the 5G in mobile antenna, so you need to have the beam forming multi-beam antenna or base station. You have to connect with multiple users. So this, I think they just demonstrated the very simple one. So the this is the lens type beam steering antenna. So lens means if you have the multiple antennas to feed the lens, you can get the multiple beam in different direction based on the this lens geometry. If the is the flat one, you can get the different type of feeding, different type of the beam. So this this is the type of the fixed beam antenna. Once you design, you cannot change the beam. This is the disadvantage. So you can generate the multiple beam based on the number of the patches. You can see here, here is the around 18 beam. So you can generate the 18 beam based on if you want to switching the beam, you can add the switch. You can see the switch four, and they use the four switch, and this the main switch to control the four switch, and the four switch can control the 16 beam because each switch is controlling the four patch. So the you can switch off one by one, or you can switch off the beam one by one in different direction. So these are the RF switch you can use, and to excite the beam based on the RF switch, you can generate the beam in different direction. So the main disadvantage of this this type of the antenna is the heavy and bulky, and you have the fixed beam. You can generate the fixed beam. You don't have the any beam resolution, the very less beam resolution. So you can see here, if you want to generate the in between two beam, you cannot generate. Once you fix the beam, the fix. So other type is the Rotman lens. The Rotman lens also is a very interesting, because this depend on the geometry. You can see here, and this is the geometry of the Rotman lens. Based on the this delay, you can generate the beam in different direction. So the here it is just to use the seven beam, and with and these are the antenna, and this is the Rotman lens input feed, and this is the antenna. They use the leaky wave antenna. You know, the leaky wave antenna can scan the frequency, can scan the beam with frequency. So in this direction, they use the leaky wave antenna to scan, and this direction, they use the Rotman lens to scan this direction. So this is the X direction, and this is the Y direction. So the this antenna can scan the 2D beam scanning, and then can they are just proposed for the use the aeroplane in the, because they use the like sector. This antenna can cover this sector, and this antenna can cover this sector like this. So, this one also can the sectorized antenna, because this antenna covers this side and this one, this and this. So the whole like one minus 92 plus 19 can cover this antenna. It's very interesting. This is the very low cost and very power, low power consumption and low cost. Only the issue here, the footprint, you need a very large footprint. Recently, I think this is very interesting. There's a one of Georgia Tech group proposed the Rotman lens to harvest the energy from the 5G. But they designed the at the Ka band, 28 gigahertz, 5G. You can see the Rotman lens can generate the beam in different direction. It can generate the six beam. You have the six antenna. You can generate the six beam based on the six input. So the in energy harvesting, you can harvest from all the direction, this direction, this direction, this direction. You can combine RF combining or DC combining. You have the hybrid combining, you can get the more. So you have the energy from this direction, and combine, you can get the more energy. If you have one beam, you can cover only this side. So this is the fixed beam, you can receive the more energy and use for the energy harvester. They call the power wireless power grid. So you can get the power wirelessly. So this is they did the experiment work also. You can see that they can receive the at least 0.6 voltage, major voltage, with distance of around 1 meter. So these are the measurement results. You can see the beam. So this one at least can cover minus 60 to plus 60 in this direction, get the energy to receive the most of power in this direction. So the other type of beam steering beam, multi-beam antenna is the transmitter antenna. So this is the transmitter antenna is the transmitter array. This will look like a metal surface type antenna because the design, if you add some different shape of the unit cell, you can add that phase in different direction differently. This is like a phase surface, phase change surface. So if you feed the, here they feed the four port, there's a four port, you can get the four beam in different direction and very easily. And they have did the experiment work on the 77 gigahertz. The main issue of these type of beam steering is the heavy, bulky, and the other type is the you can have mechanically change this. This is the also transmitting array antenna, and this is the transmit array antenna, and this is the feeder. If you change mechanical this feeder, you can change the beam direction, and this you need to change the mechanically. So they have done the experiment on 20 gigahertz, and then very interesting, you have the patch and multiple patch, you can generate the multiple beam. But this type of antenna is very bulky. You can see here it's very, very large area and heavy also. And the other type is you can use the reflect array also, same concept. If you feed and multiple feed, you can generate the reflected multiple feed. And they have designed the at 77 gigahertz. You have the different feeder to get the different feed, different beams. So they have done only the based on the three feed, and you can see here can generate the three beam in different direction. For 77 car radar, you need only the cover very, very small area, not very wide coverage, only plus minus 20 or plus minus 10. You can get the for car radar, only this coverage is enough. And the other type is the reflector antenna. You know that is like a dish type antenna. If you feed the reflector with the multiple feed, you can generate the multiple beams in different direction. And this is based on the reflector shape. You can use the double reflector, also some application to generate the multiple beams. And this is the center feed, and this is the offset feed. Also can use for generate. And this is the just these are some patterns based on the changes the D. If you change the D, the beam can generate in the different direction. You can see here angle is changed if you change this D. And some example for satellite applications, they use the dual reflector antenna to generate the beam in different direction to connect with the satellite, LEO satellite. So the other, this is the Butler matrix type. This is also fixed type. Once you design, you have the fixed beam. It depends on the number of input port and output port. Like you have the 4x4 or 8x8, you can generate the if you have 4x4, you can generate the 4 beam. If you have 8x8, you can generate the 8 beam. But only the issue is the you have a very large footprint because you need the high weight coupler, crossover to high weight coupler, you can see. And then you have the phase delay here and different phase delay. So you can see the at least the hybrid coupler need the λ/2 or lambda or this one. So the size is the issue. You can see here at the K band, the size is very large. The antenna is only this one, and this is the Butler matrix. So only the footprint, large footprint, this is the disadvantage. Otherwise you can generate the 4 beam very easily. And they have proposed for the 5G application. They generate the 4 beam and demonstrate the measurement and simulation. Also very, very good agreement you can see. So the other example, they use the 8 beam, 8x8 matrix. You can see very complex, very, very complex. And you can generate the 8 beam. And this antenna you can see here, you can cover, coverage is very, very large. You can cover almost -90 to +90. But only the issue for this type of beam steering antenna or multi-beam antenna, only the footprint size is very large. You can see this is the Butler matrix 8x8 footprint. All this is the, and this is the only antenna, and this control system tuning block. Yeah. And the Butler matrix, this one we have proposed for wireless power transfer. You have the smart home, you have dedicated RF energy transmitter. You can connect with the Butler matrix. You can generate the 4 fixed beam to charge your sensor or in the smart home. This is the one of example. One of my master student done this work for wireless power transfer. We have used the Butler matrix. You can see here, and this is the crossover, and this is the hybrid coupler, 4 hybrid coupler, and this is the crossover. This is the only the Butler matrix, and antenna is here, so you can generate the beam in different direction. This is the one of the application of the wireless power transfer using the Butler matrix 4 beam. So the other is the BLAST matrix. BLAST matrix also very interesting. So you can have the some couplers and the match load here, and you can have the some delay based on the this feeding. This is the feeding port, and these are the antenna. You can see the green one generating with this. So you have something like this, or combined delay like this. So you can have the port 1, 2, 3, 4, and generate the 4. So they have designed on 4 5G application at A band, and they have, and you can see the 4 beam in different direction can get very easily. This is also the footprint size is very large for this BLAST matrix also. Different concept, same like the Butler matrix. And this is the final one, the conformal sector antenna. You have the conformal surface. You have the, you can connect the antenna in different direction. You can generate the beam in different direction based on shooting. This is the 1D, and you can cover, this is the 2D you can cover. So that this is a very simple one, but you need the switching the beam in different direction. And the other problem of this type antenna is the very, very bulky. You can see the size is very large. So you physically changing the beam in different direction. So you just need to switch the beam in different direction you can get. But if you want to cover all 360 degree, you have like a base station, you can have the sectorized antenna in different, you still you need the beam forming in the sectorized antenna, but the coverage is like 30 degree or 60 degree can cover plus minus 30 degree. So like hexagonal can cover the plus minus 60 degree sectorized antenna whole 360 degrees. So the other, this the some recent Anka? Work.
அந்த டேபிள்க்கு சிபியுக்கு மேல
வச்சிட்டேன்க்கா மெட்டா சர்ஃபேஸ் ஆண்டினா அண்ட் எலக்ட்ரானிக் ஸ்டீர் பீம் மெட்டா சர்ஃபேஸ் ஆண்டினா யூ கேன் எலக்ட்ரானிக்கலி ஸ்டீர் த பீம் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் த மெட்டா சர்ஃபேஸ் ஆண்டினா ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த யூனிட் செல் தே யூஸ் த வெரெக்டர் டயோட் டு கண்ட்ரோல் த the phase of the this unit cell. So they have designed based on the SIW concept. This is the transition to CPW to the SIW, and this is the their product, and they claim they can use the this panel for the satellite communications. The vector diode can tune the phase, because the vector diode can change the capacitance. So capacitance means you are changing the dielectric effective dielectric constant. So based on the effective dielectric constant, you can change the phase delay, or you can change the, we can vary the delay. So based on this delay, they can tune the beam in one direction. So the one direction is the based on the vector diode, and other direction based on the passive phase shifter. So they use the passive phase shifter also, and the vector diode based on the phase tuning. So this antenna can cover the 2D scanning, one this direction and other this direction. So this direction is the based on the vector diode, and this direction based on the phase physical, this is the passive phase shifter. So this this is the their antenna system, like 8x8. This is the 8 antenna, and they connected the 8 phase shifter to generate the beam in different direction based on the vector tuning, and based on the this passive phase shifter. This is they just use the SIW. You can see the SIW, and this is the unit cell, the meta surface unit cell. You can see here, and they have designed at 10 gigahertz. You can see the scan loss is very high, because they use the vector diode. Vector diode is very lossy at the high frequency. I can show you the result of the beam. And this one is the side lobe. Side lobe, okay, minus 10, minus 45 degree, plus minus 45 degree. And this is the efficiency. You can see the efficiency is very, very low, this antenna. Because the vector diode is very lossy. Only the 8% efficiency. Only the around 8% efficiency You can see the directivity very high, around 20, but gain is the very low, around 8 dB, because due to the efficiency of this metasurface beam steering antenna is very low. Even this, the 10 gigahertz, still very low. If you're using the higher frequency Ka band, the efficiency very low, because the direct the vector diode is very, very lossy. Based on the, if you're using the at millimeter wave, this one, this antenna, this concept cannot work. You can see the very low gain and very low efficiency at 10 gigahertz. If you're using the 28 gigahertz, is very, very low, even 2%, 3% efficiency. So the other is very interesting. I think this is a, also meta surface based, and they call the digitally control the meta surface, because each unit of meta surface can control that digitally 1-0. They can control by based on the voltage, FPGA or other thing. This is the unit cell you can see here. So they use the pin diode, and there's the two condition. One is off and on. You can see this is the on, the radius pattern like this, and if you the off, radius pattern totally change because the phase is changed. You can see here reflection phase on and off, you can get the 180 degree phase difference. So you can generate the 180 degree phase difference based on the changing the digitally 1-0, like one off and on and off. So based on this concept, you can generate the different kind of patterns to generate the multi-beam and beam in different direction. And this is the just you excite the plane wave, you can generate the four beam, two beam, and the beam number of beam depend on the this pattern, how you are designing this pattern. And you can see the, if you design the rectangular shape and this is the square shape pattern, you can have the beam in the differently. So this is the just the very good paper in the Nature Scientific Communication Report, and very interesting. If you do the more research in this direction, you can, because nowadays the FPGA you can control by using the very, very good programming. You can find control of voltage, or if you're using the vector diode, you can tune the phase difference. So they have done the experiment also. You can see this is the unit cell, and this is the diode, and each diode control based on the backside, the like on off switch, so you can get the beam. And they have done the measurement and simulation. You can see the very good agreement, only the some problem, and the both side have some strong beam compared to the simulation. This is just, I think, initial paper. There are some very good paper also. If you want, if you are interesting, go the digitally controlled coding meta surface, you can get the lot of literature on this. This is very interesting also. So the other one is the digitally controlled coding meta surface. This is the 2-bit. So they have added the 2 diode. So you can generate the 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, and 1, 1. So you have the more phase change. So digitally you can generate the phase on the meta surface. You can see here. This is the 0, 0, 0, 0 pattern, and this is the 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. You can have the like this pattern, you can have the beam like this. So different pattern, you can get the different beam and different direction. So this is the mainly depend on the how you are designing the pattern and how you are controlling the each unit cell by using the biasing voltage. Biasing of the diode on off. So you can see the this the rectangle, you can get the four beam this type like this, and you want to multiple beam, you have the different pattern of the unit cell on meta surface. So you can excite, you can generate the multi beam based on the excitations. and patterns, phase patterns. So that this is the experiment they have done. So you can see here, this is the sample, and this is the transmitting horn, and this is the receiving horn. And this is the just rotating to check the beam direction. You can see the end beam in the different direction. You can have the dual beam and single beam in 30 degree. And this is that in different direction. And you have the dual beam and dual patterns. So the based on the switching on off diode, you can generate the multiple beam or single beam in different direction. So this is the just control of the diode, on off diode pattern. Like you just control this this side pattern, you can get the different direction beam like this. So this is just controlling the matter surface unit cell phase in digitally. Very interesting also. So the finally, this is the material based beam steering antenna. They have used the liquid crystals. This is the just 2x2 example. You can see the this is the element, patch element, and this is the liquid crystal element. This is the substrate. If you bias the liquid crystal, you can change the dielectric constant of the liquid crystal. So the if you change the dielectric constant, you can add some delay or phase. So that's why the beam is changed. You can see this is the like they use this spiral type of the hair patterns to generate the phase delay to excite the patch. So based on this concept, they have designed the 2x2 array pattern, and I think they have also patent also on this, and they spin off the company Elkem system based on the this design, and this year they have the product on the Ka band, and they claim they can reduce the this system is the low cost and low power consumption. And this is the German-based startup company. This is the only one company can deliver the low cost, low power consumption phaser antenna based on the liquid crystal, because they have the research center. They have the best liquid crystal to get the best tunability. Means tunability means based on the voltage, you can tune the dielectric constant on constant of the liquid crystal layer is large, like 3 to 4 or 5. So you have the more delay. So you have the more delay, you can change the beam in the different direction by controlling the voltage very fine. This antenna can get the very fine beam resolution because this is based on the voltage control epsilon, or the effective dielectric constant. So the if you control the fine voltage, you can control the fine beam scanning. So this is a very good concept based liquid crystal based phase array antenna to design the low cost and low power consumption. So these are some results for 2x2 patterns. You can see they can change the beam based on the twinning the liquid crystal. This is just a 2x2 element. Now they have the very large panel, and they are using the the LCD TV LCD as the or like our iPad as a display for antenna display, and this is very display LCD is very low cost, so they can design the very low cost antenna system for beam steering. Okay, so this is some work we have done based on the grid array antenna to steer the beam in different direction. You know that the grid antenna is the very special antenna. You know that this one grid is the grid size is the length is around lambda g and width is lambda g by 2. If you have the like this grid antenna and you feed in different direction, you can generate the beam in different direction without any phase shifter. So we call this is the phase shifterless antenna. So the in this case, we can get the delay based on the the feeding location from the center. So if you have the feeding in different, we have used the 9 feet. The one is P1, P2 in different direction, one this, and we have the 9 in different, and the 3 in these, and 3 in center, and 3 in this side. So we use the 9 port to get the beam in different direction. You can see the beam at at the center, you have the both side beam. At port 2, and we have the plus direction, x direction is 12 degree, minus x direction 11 degree, plus like this, you can change the beam in different direction. So x, direction, y direction, you can generate the beam. This is a very low cost, low profile, and smaller footprint. So this is a very good idea. We have the patent also on this. File patent, just application. So the if you look the field distribution of at the grid array antenna, you can see if you feed in this direction, the most of the field in this direction, the beam can generate this direction. If you feed this direction, excite this one, you can get the field in this direction. So in this direction, you can see if excited this one, you can have the most of the electric field in the direction, and other than this one. So if you feed this direction, you can see here most of the strong majority of the electric field in this direction. And if you excited this direction, you have this. And if you have the center, you can have this like the center majority of, and if you have the side, this here, you have the majority of electric field, and this one is this one. So the based on the 9 feet, you can get the beam in different direction. And if you add the switch of this and this antenna backside, you can steer the beam in different direction based on the switch, electronically switchable beam. So these are the 3D radiation pattern. You can see the beam in different directions based on the port selection. So this is very simple design, no need very large footprint or other you have a phase delay or phase shifter. Without phase shifter, you can generate the beam based on the feed location. Just to, if you add the RF switch on the backside, you can electronically steer the beam in different direction. So this is, we are developing, still in under development. We have compared the beam in different direction with measurement, and then you can see we can get a very good agreement between the simulated and measurement of this type of antenna. This is just we use the manually use to check the performance is compared to the measurement. It looks good. Slightly some difference in the. These are the other direction. You can see the if you have the feed in this different direction, you have the beam in different direction. The measurement and simulation is very good agreement. So we have verify this concept. The other one, same concept we use the at 93 gigahertz, because this one we want to generate the circular polarize. So this is the cross section. You can see here. This is the grid array antenna. And then we just add the polarizer, metasurface polarizer, to convert the linear polarizer to the circular polarizer. So the grid array antenna only generate the linear polarizer. So we added the metasurface circular polarizer. We just look at the circular polarization. This is the 3D view of this antenna. We just add the three port only just to get the proof of concept. If this generates the circular polarizer or not. This is the grid array antenna. This is the polarizer. You can see the we have just tilted this slanted rectangular slit type to get the circular polarizers. So this is the return loss and the mutual coupling. You can see the very good mutual coupling, less than 15 between the port, three port. And you can see here the three beam, one here and one is this one and one is the center. So the we check the axial ratio also in the three beam. You can see the beam at the center is the axial ratio and beam in this direction in the axial ratio and beam. So it means that we can generate the circular polarization based on the just put the circular polarizer on top of the grid array antenna in different direction. Okay, that's some questions you can ask. What is the disadvantage of mechanical beam steering antenna system? What is the main advantage of electronic beam steering antenna system? What is the disadvantage of lens antenna or this type of antenna and butter matrix, other things? So this topic I will cover in detail. You know the leaky beam antenna, we call also transmission type of antenna. The issue for the leaky beam antenna is the beam changing with frequency because the function of the beta omega. So the if you want to change the beam, you have to change the frequency. This is the main issue with the leaky wave antenna. You know the conventional leaky wave antenna like waveguide type or other type antenna only scan the forward direction due to the issue because you don't have the both side or backward radiation. So we can, thanks to the metamaterial force composite right left handed transmission line, to get the backward direction also and both side. So based on the CRL composite right left handed structures, you can get the beam scanning from backward to all the way both side to the end fire, or so you can continuously beam scan with frequency. This is the advantage of the metamaterial based leaky wave antenna. So you can continuously scan the beam. So conventional antenna only cover this side, only the forward direction. So the leaky wave antenna, you can generate the very narrow beam and directive beam with a very simple feed. You just have the one feed. You don't need a very two multiple feed or multiple element feed or some. The one very good advantage of this leaky wave antenna, you have the feeding configuration is very simple. You just have the very simple feed like a normal antenna. You can scan the beam. And there are different type of the leaky wave antenna, uniform waveguide, guided wave structure and periodic wave. You can have the like slit in the waveguide. You can scan the beam. And if you have the like periodic structure, you can scan beam. And it depend on the how you are designing the antenna, because in this type of antenna you have to improve the leakage if you have the best leakage, you can get the high gain. So generally around 6 lambda length have the optimum gain. After that, the gain saturate or drop. So the metamaterial, the composite right left handed transmission line for leaky wave antenna. So you know the right hand means you have the normal microstrip line or transmission line. You have the series inductance and shunt capacitance. So if you have the, if you want to the left hand, so you have to add the series capacitance and shunt inductance. So combined with two these lines, we call the composite right left handed structures. So this is the composite right left handed structures. For this structure, it can generate the beam at both side also and the backward also. So the in this case, in this design, the left hand transmission line or waveguide can generate the beam in backward direction, and right hand normal transmission line or waveguide can forward direction. This is the conventional one. The balance condition means you have the beta zero, means phase zero. So you have the balance condition. So at balance condition, you can get the both side, and this is very narrow. So you have the only one frequency point at the both side. So the combined technique, this technique can get the continuous beam scanning from backward to the forward. So we have used the SIW waveguide to design the CRL structures for leaky wave antenna. You can see here, this is the cross section of the unit cell. This is the unit cell, the one unit cell. And this is the ground plane, and this is the patch between the this slotted upper layer and the ground plane of SIW. We added the this patch to generate the capacitance, series capacitance, and this via can generate the shunt inductance. So we can get the left hand. This slot and this patch can generate the series capacitance, and this via can generate the shunt inductance. So based on this, to check the unit cell, you have to study the dispersion diagram of the unit cell. This is very important because this dispersion diagram, you can get the phase zero here. So it means this is the balance condition satisfied. If not satisfied, if it's not zero, then you will not get the both side radiation. This is the very important. And the other one to check the for leaky wave antenna, this type of leaky wave antenna, to the right hand and left hand region, frequency region. For generally, the left hand is the narrow band compared to the right hand. This is the one of the challenge of designing the composite right left handed leaky wave antenna, how to get the same bandwidth in both region, left hand region and right hand region. So recently I have one master student, so she designed the one antenna to get the both region in the same bandwidth. This is the one of the very, very big challenge, how to get the same bandwidth. So we have designed this antenna, unit cell, and then based on this unit cell, we have used the 15 unit cell to design the leaky wave antenna. So the this one we have studied first the how many unit cell can get the how much gain. So we just vary the number of unit cell with to check the gain. You can see the and up to 15 up to 15 or 20 you have the gain very large change from 5 to 20. After that, not big change because the power leakage is saturated. So that we just use the for demonstration the 15 number of unit cell 15 for our design, and then we have also checked the gain variation with the number of unit cell with frequency. You can see if you have the only 5 unit cell, you have the gain very less with frequency band. And if you have the 35, if you change the 5 to 15, is drastical change from 5 to 10. So we just use the our design in 15. So after that, if you change the 25, is not a big change, and it's 35 also not so big change. So and then we have checked the beam scanning with frequency and gain. You can see the this is the beam scanning angle. You can scan from minus 75 to plus 75. With the gain. Yeah. This is the beam scanning with frequency, and this is the gain with frequency. And this is just a radiation pattern in different direction and at different frequency. You can see the if you change the frequency, you have the beam in different direction. At the both side, 8.95, because the 8.95. And the balance condition is satisfied here. So you can get the both side radiation. So this is the just 3D radiation pattern in different frequency. And the other problem for this type of antenna, because if you change the frequency, the beam width also change. You can see here. And here the very wider beam compared to the center beam. You can see the beam width. This is also one of the challenges, how to design the constant beam scan or beam width antenna. So the we have fabricated. Compare the with simulations. So the we have added the simple feed as a SME here, you can see here, and we have measured antenna. The S parameter S11. This is the S11 measurement, and this is the simulated one. And you can see the very good agreement. And this is the S21, and S21 also have the very good agreement. And you can see the measured and the scanning, measured beam scanning with frequency is very good agreement with the simulated one. And you can scan from minus 70 to plus 70. And this is the gain with frequency. Is a very good agreement. It's slightly some difference. So these are the radiation patterns. You can see the radiation patterns in this is the left hand region, and the beam width is a wider. Is low frequency. If you go frequency higher, then beam width is change. This is the narrow beam. At the both side, you can see the very narrow band, narrow beam. And this is the left hand. You can see the beam. The both side and left hand is okay. But if you go the end fire is further change the beam width. So this is the one of the challenge, how to get the consistent beam width of the beam with frequency. This is the also one challenge to design. So the next, we have done the combine the two dual antenna structure, leaky wave antenna structure. You can see the one antenna have the slanted slot compared to the other antenna. So in this work, our plan to get the wider both side radiation bandwidth. So we combine two antenna. So the both side gain is very important. Both side beam is very important because leaky wave antenna can design narrow beam. So this is the unit cell. You can see the dual unit cell. One is slanted and one is rectangle, the planar. So we have added the same patch, parasitic patch below the slot. You can see here, this is the parasitic patch layer and this is the slot. And then we have studied with the unit cell again with the dispersion diagram, and this one dispersion based on the dispersion diagram, the both side balance condition at 9 gigahertz. Then we have compared the antenna with the dual and with the single structure. You can see because our aim is to design the both side wider bandwidth. You can see the if you have the dual leaky wave antenna, you can enhance the beam bandwidth of the both side radiation. This is the both side radiation of the leaky wave antenna. You can see here the single leaky wave antenna, this one have only the 175 megahertz bandwidth at the both side port side radiation. If you add the one more antenna, one more leaky wave antenna with slanted slot, you can have the 375 megahertz. And gain also improve for dual band because the aperture increase. So the bandwidth almost double, both side radiation bandwidth almost double compared to the single layer leaky wave antenna. This one with again we have studied the number of dual unit cell. You can see in this case is almost saturate at the 15 unit cell. After that is almost flat. So that's why we have used the 15 unit cell. And this is the just comparison with the cross pole. This is the cross pole. And this is the dual element antenna gain at both side, and these two are the single element both side radiation. One is the slanted single and one is the vertical slanted antenna. So you can see the dual element leaky wave antenna is the higher gain and very consistent at with the frequency, wider frequency band. And then we have compared the change the combination of the slanted one. You can see the if you have the 45 degree slanted, you have the wider bandwidth compared to the 15 and 30 and 60. So we have studied a lot with the change the this slanted angle, which one is the best angle. So the around 45 is the best combination to get the larger bandwidth at the both side radiation. And this is the just comparison with the dual element leaky wave antenna and single vertical and single slanted 45 degree slot. So you can see the dual element leaky wave antenna have the advantage over the single leaky wave antenna. We have fabricated to check the performance, measure performance. We can see the very good agreement of the S parameter. And this is the only the advantage of the leaky wave antenna, very simple feeding. No need very, very complex feeding to get the beam scanning. And you can see the both side beam bandwidth. We can get the very good comparison of the gain at both side of this antenna. And this is the main motivation of this work is to get the wider port side radiations. Because this balance condition very sensitive. If this fabrication tolerance, if some fabrication problem or the material tolerance is changed, so you will not get the port side radiation. If a wider band, you can always get the port side. So we have measured the maximum gain with the frequency. You can see it's very good agreement with the simulated and measurement. And this is the comparison of the beam scanning angle and the 3 dB beam width. So this is the beam scanning with the frequency. You can see the very good agreement with simulated and measurement. Dotted line is the measurement and the solid line is the simulated one. So if you check the beam width, right? So the beam width is changed. This the you know that this is the left hand region. So left hand region has the wider beam width compared to this region. This is the port side, and after that this is the right hand region. So right hand region almost have consistent beam width of the beam. And compared to the left hand, this is the one of and disadvantage. If you have the consistent beam width, then it's very good for system designer and other thing. And the other main disadvantage, this is not a linear beam scanning with frequency. If you have the linear beam scanning with frequency, it's very good for system designer. So this one, this is also very challenging, and we are working on this. We are almost get. So these are the radiation pattern, major radiation patterns. You can see this is the left hand region, the different beam. You can see the wider beam and then change the beam width with change the frequency. And this is the both side. You can see the different frequency. We can get the both side radiation. This is the main motivation of this paper. And you can see this is the right hand region. You can have the beam in the different frequency in the different direction. So we added the same slot angle on just a vertical slot. This just for conference paper. We are just get. We have some improvement, but is not like slanted and one vertical compared to this one. This is not so good. So the slanted and one vertical is combination is good to get the wider both side radiation. This is the both side radiation. Okay. So this is another work. Related to the taper. If you have the taper slot, like smaller, bigger, or this is the smaller and then the slightly bigger and the bigger, you can also get the wider both side radiation. So this concept we have designed, and then we check that unit cell is same. Just change the slot on the top. And this is the smaller and bigger and bigger like this. So this based on this concept, because this is the aperture, we control the leakage, right? based on the leakage control, you can also get the wider bandwidth at the bore site. You can see it's very, very good compared to the non-taper. This is the non-taper. Non-taper is the very narrow band bore site gain. And if you look this one, taper one, you can get the very wide band, but slightly less gain, but with the wider bandwidth. So this is the fabricated prototype, and this is the measurement and the simulated, very good comparison. And this is the major result in different frequency in at the bore site. Okay, this is just S parameter S11 and S21. The good agreement between the measurement and the simulated one. And this is the gain with frequency measured and simulated. And this is again the comparison of the beam scanning with frequency measured and simulated. And this is the beam width. 3 dB beam width measurement and the simulated one. You can see the good agreement. And I just discussed this, the issue for the left-hand region have wider beam width compared to the right-hand region. So these are the measured and simulated radiation pattern in the left-hand region, both side region, and right-hand region. And this is the another one, taper slot SIW-based leaky wave antenna. This is the same concept. In this case, we continuously change this slot size like this, the smaller, bigger, and biggest. So this one also we can get the almost better result compared to the previous one. And we have fabricated this also in major performance. You can see the very good agreement, major simulated one. And these are, you can see the, these all different frequency have the gain, the beam in the both side direction, one direction. For this design, we are trying to get some linear scanning with frequency based on the dumbbell type slot. You can see compared to the previous example, and in this case, we are improving some linear scanning with this frequency. You can see here, this is the planar type, and if you have the slot, you can improve some this angle. Still, we are working. I think we are almost at the linear beam scanning with frequency. Still, this is ongoing work. So this is very, very important to simplify the system configuration. So we have fabricated and measured this one. So for measurement, because this is the two ports, so you have to one port, output port, we have to put the match load to if you are measuring the radiation pattern or the S11. So the this one, this work we have done for millimeter wave for scanning the crack in the pipe or oil pipe, metallic pipe. So this one, we have the patent, and we have designed full scanning system at millimeter wave to get the very, very fine resolution of the crack, because you know the crack is very fine in the oil pipe or in any metallic pipe or metallic surface. So for detection or for crack detection, we have developed the this scanning system based on the leaky wave antenna, and this leaky wave antenna can enhance the scanning speed because the beam can move. I scan the large area based on the beam scanning like this. If you have the single beam, you have cover only very small spot only. So this this antenna can cover the very wide coverage and enhance the scanning speed more than double. So that's why this work we have patented. and also licensed to some then we have designed the same for 77 gigahertz or 77 for car radar. You can see the we can scan the beam at for car radar you need only very narrow scanning coverage, so only plus minus 20 is okay. And this is just an example for other papers. If you have the two combination of antenna array, leaky wave antenna, you have the 4 feet, right? So you can control the beam based on the these 4 feet. This is the one leaky wave antenna, this is the another one. So based on the this feeding port configuration, you can get the beam in different direction at the fixed frequency. Because if you feed here, you will get the one beam. If you feed here, you can beam the other beam in the other direction. So this is the leaky wave quality. If you feed in this direction, you get the beam in this direction. If you feed in the direction, you can get the beam in other direction. So based on the 4 feeding, you can get the beam in different directions. So this is also very good concept to use the switching based beam scanning, very simple way to get to cover the plus minus 70 plus 17 or 20 degree for car radar or any smaller coverage applications. So this is other example for 2D scanning system, how to design the 2D scanning system based on the leaky wave antenna. So they have combined, you can see I presented the Butler matrix. They use the 8x8 Butler matrix to connect the 8 leaky wave antenna. You can see here the 8 port for Butler matrix and the 8 output for Butler matrix connected the leaky wave antenna. So the leaky wave antenna can scan this direction, and based on the Butler matrix can scan this direction. So this overall system can get the two-dimensional beam scanning. So this is the unit cell they have designed. You can see the unit cell phase zero at the around 11 gigahertz, means the beta is zero, so you can get the at this frequency both sides. So they have developed at this frequency to get the two-dimensional beam scanning. So you can see the 8 beam in different direction based on this Butler matrix concept. So they have combined, I can say this is the hybrid combination of the beam steering antenna system for 2D scanning. And this is a very interesting. They use the vector diode for each unit cell. You can see this is the unit cell, and this is the unit cell, and they use the vector diode and the biasing using the vial. So you can see that if you change the vector diode biasing, you can change the this is the balance condition. Balance condition means you can change the both side radiation with changing the vector diode capacitance. So in different frequency, you can get the both side radiation at a different frequency. So you can get the tunable leaky wave antenna design based on the vector diode. So if you apply the voltage at the fixed frequency, you can get the beam in different directions. So this is also very interesting design to design the beam steering antenna based on the vector diode. But vector diode only for low frequency, okay. But if you go the high frequency, it's very lossy. So loss is a big issue. And this is the Another example for liquid crystal based leaky wave antenna. You know, the leaky wave antenna is the frequency based scanning. So if you want to make the fixed frequency independent scanning, so you have to add the liquid crystal, and based on the liquid crystal, you can change the balance condition. If you change the balance condition frequency, you can scan the beam in different direction based change on the voltage of the liquid crystal. So if you change the voltage of the liquid crystal permittivity change, and based on the change of permittivity, you can design the antenna, you can tune the antenna in different frequency at both side also, because you can change the balance condition, or you can, if you have the scanning right hand, you can scan the fixed frequency, like they use the 12 gigahertz. So you, at 12 gigahertz, you can scan the right hand region in different, based on the voltage change, the different region. So the and the fixed region, you can tune the beam at fixed frequency. This is the advantage of the liquid crystal if you're using the leaky wave antenna. So the these are some applications of the leaky wave antenna. So the this is the frequency scanning radar. So you can detect the based on the frequency, you know, the based on the frequency direction of the beam. So based on the knowing the direction of the beam with frequency, you can use the leaky wave antenna as a radar to detect the human or other scanning or target. You just need very simple system. Just use the circulators or this RX pulse or the receiving and the transmitting using the circulator. So you can get the knowledge of the which area the human is there or not. So you can use the tracking the humans or other things, because the beam is the based on the direction frequency. Frequency is the based on the beam is the based on the frequency. So based on the frequency, you know the direction of the beam. So based on the direction of the beam, you can know the target. Which area is the human or this? This one is very good example. The other one, you go in scanning for imaging or detection. So you go the airport, so you have to scan. Have any metallic part or any gun or knife? So you can use the, because in this area, you can use the frequency scanning. And if you put the all around there, so you can scan the whole area. Or like this is just an example. In this paper, you can see the very good image based on this frequency scanning antenna. So they have one receiver, wideband receiver, and this is the transmitter. This is moving like this. So you can get the image of this metallic part in this paper. So other is the hand gesture sensing. If you have the very wide band, and this because this leaky wave antenna is very sensitive with the hand gesture, because this is a very narrow beam and with the frequency change. So we can use the detection or sensing the humans, or can use the these antenna for the application. The other application is the sensor for imaging. If you have the dual sensor, one in this direction and one other direction, you can scan the in both direction very nicely, because you can see the this direction, you can scan this direction, all the direction, and this direction, you can scan this one. So the for imaging or other purpose is very good for scanning and detections and imagings. And there's some tracking radar. They use the leaky wave antenna for tracking the vehicles or other. Is there some good examples for these type of antennas? And this is also radar imaging. You can use the this type of antenna in for imaging. And you can use the vertical or horizontal in two way. You can scan the area for imaging. So this is my conclusion of today's talks. So I have presented various type of beamforming, beamstring antenna, and some overview of the different kind of beamstring antenna. And I have presented the grid array antenna system for beam scanning application at millimeter wave. And I have presented some single SIW based leaky wave antenna, dual SIW based leaky wave antenna, and tapers SIW based leaky wave antenna. And for I think the takeaway from this presentation is how to design the smartly beam string antenna with low cost, wider angle, and low power consumption. This is the three main challenge in this technology, beam forming technology. So thank you everyone for listening the very long talk. So if you have questions, any things, you can ask me.
Thank you, sir, for such a wonderful session. Any doubts from the participant side, you can ask.
Sir, how you have realized the composite left-handed and right-handed transmission line? Can you explain once again?
Yeah. Because for left-hand region, you need a shunt series capacitance and shunt inductance. So in SIW waveguide, you have the VR, right? So that VR can generate the shunt inductance. And I have the one patch below the slot. And that slot and the patch in between the waveguide, SIW waveguide, can generate the series capacitance. So this is the trick to generate the left hand in the right hand waveguide.
Slot will act as a series capacitance?
A slot and with the patch below. You know the patch is the below, right? In between. That can get the series capacitance. Okay.
And what about the right hand?
Right hand is the simple waveguide, right? Okay. Just normal microstrip line or anything. Okay. Because if you have the simple waveguide or microstrip line, is the right hand.
Oh. Okay.
And if you want to the bore side gain, so the right hand and left hand, so the beta should be zero. So energy at the left hand region, right hand region should be equal. So you can get the bore side radiation. So conventional leaky wave antenna, you cannot get the, even you cannot get the bore side and the left backside radiation. So the conventional antenna only right hand region. So this is the advantage, this is the real advantage I have seen in the metamaterial for backside radiation, left hand region. Otherwise it's not so useful for metamaterial for antenna.
Sir, only slot will act as a means series capacitance?
No. Slot plus patch. You know the slot and below is the patch, right? Combine.
And you can. Yes, Kumar, you can ask your doubt.
You can do the other way also. If you have the slot and then put the patch on the slot, also can generate.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Hello, sir. This is Abhay. I am from JP Institute, Noida. Actually, I'm working on the same technology of SIW and a slot-based antenna, normally for a lower frequency. Sir, I just like to ask, since you have shown few of the antennas working near about like 60 or to 70 gigahertz, so which type of substrate normally you prefer? Because here we used to take 5870 or 5.0.
We use RO4003C.
Okay, so normally we have several challenges in making the antennas out of that, because there are various constraints when we drill some like wires. It's a soft material. So how you tackle all those things for a higher frequency range, sir?
Which material? Soft material? You are using RT-Doride?
I'm using RT-Doride 5870.
RT-Doride is not good for SIW waveguide. It's very flexible.
So you are using, sir, RO4003, right?
RO4003 is very best.
So what is the effective permittivity of that particular?
3.5.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you, sir.
You can check in the Google. I think you can get the all parameter.
So is that particular material good for the SIW fabrications for a higher frequency?
Yeah. Because if you look, the RT-Doride is very flexible. If you have the VR, right?
Right, sir.
That have some problem if you are flexible.
Okay, sir. One more question, sir. Are there any ways in which we can collaborate, or we can send our research scholars to you? Is there any way? Is this some openings are there?
Because our institute is directly, I cannot take, because it's very, very, for our institute, if ranking of the university is very high, then we can collaborate.
Okay, sir.
So the we can do like this. If you have the student, we can collaborate the research based on the student. I can guide the student.
Mostly, sir, we have the work in the SIW. Normally, we started with the application at 30 gigahertz for a millimeter wave applications. And due to some fabrication issues and testing issues, we come down to for KU band applications of 15 or like below 18 gigahertz. So that's why we are normally in the same field in which you have shown all those things. But we haven't used the different types of diode for these beam steerings and other things. But still, we are trying our best to just do that thing for a lower frequency range.
I think this is a very good area for, because the 5G and the in coming year, and this is a very hot topic, because you need the connectivity, and for connectivity you need the beam forming antenna. If you design the low cost beam forming antenna any way, it's very, very good. Maybe some breakthrough if you have the very interesting area. Because now all company, because we have always discussed with the company, the companies are looking, I think, solution. Is there no solution in the market?
Right, sir.
How to design the low cost, low power consumption, and the wide coverage. These are the three things you can focus. Right, even you can solve the one problem, right? You will get reward.
So normally we used to have a slot in a SIW resonator. And since we have a multiple slot, we create an array of those particular slots. So we get a very high gain for an automotive radar applications. And if we can integrate these things with beam steering and other thing, hopefully we would get a better results, and we can propose those things for industrial purpose also.
Because I just presented one antenna, right? A metamaterial based beam steering antenna. That one is the one of the company, startup company work.
Right, sir.
They have designed, you know, the K-Meta is very popular for this type of antenna, but still they're trying to the K-band, but due to the loss at K-band, because efficiency is very low.
Yes, sir.
Using the vector diode. If you have to replace the vector diode, maybe you can solve the problem.
Right, sir. So what are the future for frequency reconfigurable antennas, as you have shown these things initially?
I mentioned the challenge, right?
Right, sir.
If you have the beam scanning with linearly with frequency, you can use this antenna for system.
Right, sir.
Otherwise,
right,
very difficult, because the beam scanning is not consistent with the frequency. is right, a sir. Figure like this.
Right.
So I think one of my students just this year have designed a very interesting area. She can get the very good linear scanning with frequency. Right.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Work on this. I think this may be the, you can get the, at least the transaction if you solve this problem.
Right, sir. Right, sir. Actually, we started with the higher frequencies. So we started with the SIW horn antennas. We get a very good results in that. And we get a very high gain when we combine those things in an NF format. But still, for that, we design the feeding structure, completely feeding structure, which is noble in our case. So we are working in this fashion, and we try to achieve a high gain antenna for mostly for the automotive radar applications. Mm-hmm. And we have several questions right now over here also, like we cannot able to detect the drones. So we have several drone attack in India also. So
yeah, you need high gain. You need high gain.
Yeah, yeah. We need high gain. Even we are the range of the drone is very, very low. So we are not able to track those things with the help of the radars. So these might be the things which we can use with the help of the SIW antennas.
Yeah.
We can achieve. Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot.
Hello.
Yeah.
Good evening, sir. Hello. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Yeah.
Sir, how to design microstrip patch antenna by using ceramic composite materials?
Ceramic composite material.
Yes.
You can design, you know the permittivity, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, based on the permittivity, you can get the lambda G by 2. And this is a very simple.
Sir, actually, the composite material gets more than 20-24 like that I have obtained, sir. Sir, how to design more directivity permittivity by using HFSS software? Is it possible to design simulation bots, sir?
Everything
by using composite materials?
Everything is possible.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Is a dielectric constant is more, no, sir. Permittivity is more.
Yeah, you have the 30.
Actually,
no matter. You have the 100,
yes,
1000. You can design, right? It,
yes,
it depends on the lambda G. You just calculate lambda G. Based on that, you can calculate the size of the patch antenna, because the now the people designing the antenna using as a seawater
yes,
as a antenna.
Yes,
you have the continuously water dropping, right? They use
yes,
it as a monopole antenna for seawater.
Yes, sir.
So the
direction
is not a big issue.
I have seen more wafers, sir, below 10 or 8 or something dielectric permittivity values, sir. More, I mean, less than 10 RT Jurider, Rogers, and like that. So many materials are available, no, sir.
It's
dielectric permittivity is very less when compared to the composite materials, sir. Its design is very easy when compared to the composite materials. Its dielectric permittivity is more, no, sir.
I cannot get what you want to try to
more. Actually, in composite materials, I have obtained more dielectric permittivity, sir.
Yeah.
In the designing part, it is I am unable to design microstrip patch antenna by using more dielectric permittivity.
How much is the dielectric permittivity?
24, sir.
This way is no problem. You just calculate the square root of epsilon R and then calculate the patch length and
yes,
just feed.
Okay, sir. Okay, I'm not sure. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
No problem. It's okay.
Thank you.
Any other comment or question or want to discuss some issue? Professor Gautam, you are looking sleepy.
Okay, sir. We'll in future definitely collaborate for certain research.
Yeah, sure. No problem.
Thank you very much once again.
I think you are tiring. Whole week you are arranging this thing. It's very long week.
Actually, today I'm setting question paper for the participant.
Okay.
So it takes a lot of women's mind.
You have exam, so you can ask whatever you want now.
Participants. You can ask.
If you have
doubt. You have an examination.
You have examination, right? I don't know. but I think this technology, beamforming technology, is very, very good in future, for future.
It can be a breakthrough, sir.
I think
aspect is very important.
Work on this direction, maybe some breakthrough. This is a good area to explore.
Yes, sir.
Because the one antenna system for beamforming is very expensive. $25,000. $25,000. Even K-Meta, we check the cost. Only very simple, like this panel, $25,000.
Mm-hmm.
Very expensive technology.
Okay.
So, from modern side, can you please ask something, or we have to conclude the session?
Any more doubts, please? If you want, you can ask. Not every day we have an expert. Such a good.
I don't think anybody is interested to ask anything.
Okay, I think thank you so everyone for listening to so long, 2 hour talks.
Thank you so much, sir, for sparing us precious time.
Because they are listening since morning.
Yeah. Maybe now tired.
maybe they are
exhausted.
Yeah. Because first time.
Sir, thank you so much.
First time I am also giving the 2 hour. Otherwise, only the 1 hour or 45 hours.
Yeah.
Generally 45 hours.
Actually, normally thing is, we thought you may give a session for one and a half hours and 30 minutes for the discussion.
Yeah. But nobody want to discuss, right?
Yeah. That's a big problem. In fact, all of them are mainly out of them are faculty members, and still the. I don't know why they are not involving in discussion.
Because one of the professor came to Singapore to talk. So she bring some gift to ask the questions. So she gave the one gift if somebody asked the question. So that's why if you ask the question, you can improve yourself or
definitely.
You can have some idea.
Many things you will get clear.
Yeah. So thank you, professor, everything. And thank you all.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Bye-bye. Take care.
I can touch in future.
Yeah, sure. Okay. Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye-bye, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, then Rishi.
So we'll conclude the session then.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Thank you all the participants.
Hello. Hello.
Yes.
I am Abhijit Ghosh. I think I have two questions. One is... how do you take exam? And second question is the recording of this all lecture recording you are provide to our any portal or
actually
or material this... before exam?
No, that's not possible. The very basic questions we are going to ask. If you have attended the session, then it's not so tough. So if you talk about the recording actually for 2 hours, it becomes more than 1 GB storage. So it becomes very difficult to us to share these to maybe through the mail or WhatsApp.
Sir,
so what we are planning? We are planning to...
I have not asked only this guy or this professor. I ask all the recording you are provided or not. Or any PPT or any material like that, you are anything is provided or not?
No, till now we have not provided anything, but we are trying to provide you links for the all the sessions.
Yes. How exam you taken, MCQ base or?
In that the MCQ. MCQ.
Okay.
What so is can we know whether
you can easily solve the exam. It's not so tough.
Now, whether it is in the morning or in the evening?
That will be in evening. Maybe around 3 o'clock.
Okay.
And one more thing, it is very you make it clear, because examination is very important. You have to secure 60% marks, isn't it? Otherwise you will not get your certificate.
For that reason I ask. I know that these things, 80% yeah. attendance and 60% marks.
Sir, any we have to log in through Adal login, something like that, and we have to take that ID.
No, sir. A link will be there. We will provide a link.
Okay.
By which you can submit your examination.
Okay.
But
provided in WhatsApp group.
Yeah, definitely WhatsApp group.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, and another thing is, all of you, please go to your Atal account, and you have to give feedback of the FTP over there. Okay, until unless you provide your feedback, you will not able to get download your certificates. Okay, so you have to give feedback through your Atal ID pass.
That is after completing the entire course,
tomorrow session, no issue, or day after tomorrow, you know, okay. You don't have an issue.
Okay.
But thing is, until unless you do it, then only you will get your certificates.
Okay.
Another thing, I already asked two questions. So last, not is the question, it is just a request. The physical FDPs happen, so obviously just a small tour of your institute. Also your small tour in your institute as well as your area. So you are providing WhatsApp group any virtual tour in your institute or virtual tour near your area, like that it is possible. So it is just I not formally ask, I informally ask this question.
No. Okay. You belong to which place?
I Kolkata.
Kolkata. So ever have you visited Rishikesh or Haridwar?
Right now it is not possible. Means
I'm asking whether you have visited this place and in past or not?
No, when I visit, I eat very small.
Okay. So if you talk about our institute, it's located in beautiful mountains of Himalaya, Shivalik Range.
So like that, any virtual tour or video is possible to provide in WhatsApp group in your institute?
Let me try. If it is possible, then we can share it. Because we
it's
have
available in YouTube already available in YouTube also.
Yeah. That's also available in
all. So this YouTube link also provide in WhatsApp group.
That we can do.
Okay.
That is possible.
And, just it is informally I demand these things. Informally I demand these things.
That is fine.
No issue. In fact, we'll be happy if you visited our institute. And we are open to extend our facilities to anyone from out of here. So, because we have facilities for fabrication as well as for measurement, including NI chamber and other things. So we can collaborate in any way. No issue.
So can you tell me the frequency of an analog chamber utilized in your institute?
That is up to 20 gigahertz.
Do you have a measurement facility at your college, sir?
Yeah, at our college.